All right, I'm hitting record now as we begin our journey. I guess I don't need the snakes anymore. Bye, snakes. We're going vanilla.
That mug.
Assuming the disc even reads. Oh, it's back. It's back to a default save file of New Game Plus, so the flowers are white again. When you get past the torture sequence, the flowers turn red. It doesn't. These fucking file names. I might have experimented in modern times with Tony Hawk 3, as you might guess by the OC names littering it. I have Beyond Good and Evil in here for somehow. I don't remember getting that.
Yeah, check voice text real quick.
Check voice text, huh? Oh, cool. What happened to his other ear? Do you want me to put this on this fucking stream?
Do as you will.
Okay. I will. I'm going to name
I
it Raw
will.
Mug. Right, we have a friend now. We have a friend for stream.
God. I don't know why he's so
I forget.
just
Is there
being
blending?
that
Is it in
reflective in a
blending?
white void makes it look wet.
A little bit. Is there like a built-in chroma key thing? I can't remember how that works in OBS. I realize I'm probably asking the wrong people. But I can pretend that I'll get answers. There might be streamers in the chat. Anyways, is this disc spinning or what? We have to see. We have to find out. Can at least trim some of this negative space. It's bugging me. I think I got this for like $2 at a book off. Yeah, I can read that.
Don't worry
Go
about it.
Nami. That guy.
Yeah.
Whoa! Right on, Gromit.
Are you looking at? Oh. Is he okay? I think I don't think he's okay.
No, it's fine. The wear curse will heal him.
I saw that movie in theaters, and I remember very little. I
I
remember
think
it being
I
all
was
right.
reading as well. Bergman's pretty strong.
Manage games. No save games. Let's go. Wallace and Gromit caught uses an autosave feature. Whenever you see that icon, do not remove memory card PS2, memory card slot 1, controller, or reset slash switch off the console. I hope we collect cheese of some kind.
It feels almost necessary.
Like, I hope there's a distinct cheese collectible. Like Corgi tells all.
It says the town's overrun with pests, and they're eating everything in sight. Antipesto,
I watched Chicken Run relatively recently. It was a good time.
It's a good movie. A major
infestation. Don't worry, my lady. We'll be over in two shakes of a rabbit's tail.
The classic cartoon setup of doing whatever job the plot deems necessary. Inventor is not a job.
But we'll get you to the vegetable show in time. Come on, Gromit, shift a paw.
Much obliged, Mr. Wallace, I'm sure. And as one good turn deserves another, let me see what the future holds for you and your canine companion.
Leave Gromit out of this.
I see rabbits, lots of them. And by the light of the moon, I see one particularly large and ravenous rabbit. So watch your step in the battle with the pests, lest you unleash powers you can't control. Oh, and one more thing. Beware crossing the path of a tall, dark stranger.
Well, anyways. This seems so far to be abridged movie plot. Oh yeah, how's that guy?
Can I help you?
Actually, yeah. We're here to help you. We're Antipesto.
Antipesto? Yes, I've heard of you. Humane pest control. Namby-pamby nonsense. Only one way to deal with pests, and that's shoot 'em. Shoot 'em where it hurts.
Victor, that's quite enough about shooting. You know my views on that.
Of course, of course. Goodness, how well you look today. You're positively glowing with wealth. I mean, dripping with health.
I'd be feeling a great deal better if we had our pest problem under control. They seem to be everywhere. Now you must
fucking
be
weird. You're just the man I've been. Like, this is pretty much just the movie so far.
Yeah. Just the
sort of client. Except I imagine less carrots, charming intricacy. Defending.
Humane. Just a little. Control.
Stuff and nonsense. Antipesto will never rid Lady T of her rabbits or her riches. I'll make sure of that.
Crikey. Even armed with our bun gun, Gromit's gonna need extra training to deal
He's
with
gonna need a tutorial.
Luckily, I put together this. Nope, still Australian.
First things first, lad. Let's have a quick look around.
Okay. You rotate the gamer. Wow.
Right, old Gromit.
Rotate the stick, Gromit.
Tottington. See what she wants doing.
Okay. Oh, this camera could. Why is it a zoom out?
Come on, Gromit. Better talk to the lady.
This feels weird. It's oddly sluggish. Whoa.
Talk to lady.
Okay. Okay. I thought he teleported like that one Sherlock Holmes game. Alright, what's up?
Ah, you're here to help us.
Known chatterbox Gromit.
You simply must clear the lawn of rabbits before Victor resorts to more traditional methods. He may look
I wanna say like these voice her and Victor were like celebrity cameos.
Maybe
I do hope you
But I don't remember what the casting was.
Right, first we need to start the van.
Tell Wallace to start van. Alright.
Helena Bonham Carter is Toddington.
Okay, yeah. You can whistle, can't you?
Teamwork is our watchword.
Let's Ralph Fiennes as the hunter?
I don't recognize that. This
Lord
effect
Voldemort.
Is fucked up. Oh.
And Alfred in the Lego Batman movie.
Huh.
He was also in Grand Budapest Hotel, Red Dragon. I've seen some of those. I don't know who he played, but he was in them.
Dunk. Yeah, there you go. I love Luigi's Mansion. Classic Wallace yell.
Our names are Wallace, Gromit, and Gromit.
I'm clogging the rest of them.
Do all 30 of them one at a time. Play the video game, Gromit. This is like a recurring nightmare for Daisy, isn't it?
Why do they keep calling me the fat rabbit? What do you mean you spell it with a PH?
What do you mean two C's?
This rabbit's taking me across the yard, man. I don't understand. I don't know about this.
In my silent dreams, I see those eyes. Those empty eyes. Looks in the right corner.
Make sure you pull away from the rabbit.
Herschel, give me the bun gun. Yes, dear. What the fuck am I missing here? What? Do I have to...
Have you not played Luigi's Mansion?
I'm stupid. I was not understanding Luigi's Bunsen. Can I run? No. Oh, oops.
Oh, we're back to square one.
Okay. No, we got this. We got this.
How far is crackers?
That's pretty good.
Let's show off our vans.
Yeah.
Yes, please, let's catch more than one at once.
Yep.
It grinds them into paste. Humanely.
That should make things easier.
You still have to get them one at a time, lad.
Look sharp. There's another load of rabbits. See if you can chase them towards one of those
dragons. There you go. Start corralling.
If you run at them, they'll herd into a group. Slow down, and you'll get more control.
Yeah, the sprites are a little...
Oh, I got a little sneaky. I'm a sheepdog. Get in there.
Now that's what I call fast. Here comes the last.
You sneaking?
It's a little. If you slow walk, you start doing a little sneaky.
Oh, so I'm done. I did it.
What did you do? Oh, Mass Effect?
Yep. The last of the 127 Legendary Edition achievements.
Gross.
Yeah.
Why do you do that to yourself? Your silence speaks volumes, truly. Hey, what's this? Collectibles. Literally just the tutorial level. Hey everybody, let's get in the hole, okay?
Well, that seems to be the lot. Looks like Lady Tottington wants a word.
Who is that marvelous dog? The, like, compression on this... And... It's not much better on my TV, though it is does seem to actually genuinely be supporting a form of widescreen, which is pretty impressive. The stream preview compression makes this look like a pre-rendered like game pre-rendered cutscene from 1993. This is PS1 era pre-rendered cutscene. Oh, he's looking at me. Oh, he's actively looking at me. Now he's flexing. And then he goes back to looking straight at me. Gromit, look over there.
Ah, that was quick. And they're all safe in there, are they? Here's a little something for your troubles.
Well, Mr. Pope,
she's doing like a rabbit hand thing almost. Like a weird crossed paws and you got the teeth. I don't know. If that's intentional.
I have another tiny task for you. The old walled garden has been overrun, and the butler's prize pumpkin is in peril. If you wouldn't mind clearing
not the
that
prize
area,
pumpkin.
Okay, I'd be
perish the thought.
Come on, lad, hop to it. Can't keep it's round this side of the house.
I watched like the hell out of the Wallace and Gromit shorts.
I should go back sometime. I don't
back
think
in
I
the day.
It's been a while and I don't think I watched all of them.
I've got it.
I've got it.
Oh, that's what I call suction.
The gate's blocked by that. Love to hear that.
Just jump on that pile of
lock. I want that isolated, honestly.
Just get that Wallace talk sprite as an emote.
All these talk sprites. Jump, right. Sorry, you're trying to teach me to jump. Famous double jump skill from Gromit. Now, run up to the
gate sharpish and I genetically engineered you to be able to do that.
If the butler's pumpkin's pulverized, we'll have failed.
It's the video game.
Before we release any of the rabbits in our anti-pesto traps, we'd better unblock the vac drain.
Mm-hmm.
I can see it under that trolley.
Hey, look at that.
You're gonna have to move it out of the way.
Push the box.
So one of the...
Get that. Off the drain,
licensed right? PS2 games I have is the Over the Hedge licensed game.
Yeah, how's that? Actually, there's I think I vaguely recall you talking about it.
There's so much more of the game past just the stuff that covers the plot of the movie.
Yeah, one of those.
Yeah. It's like a weird four-player 3D brawler.
All right. That's a movie I also remember thinking was all right. Oh, I'm over here. There's a lot of motion, interactivity. Get it into the back
drain. Just smack the fucking thing into the hole.
Now, last but not least, let's empty our trap next to the butler's pumpkin. Grab hold of the winch.
Crikey, what a lot of bunnies. They're eating the pumpkin. Stop them. Don't worry about the smaller vegetables. Just herd the rabbits over to the drain as fast as you can.
I'm seeing the fundamentals here. I'm getting it. Get out of here from those cans.
Right. Reverse. There must be more rabbits hiding here
somewhere. I see one.
Oh, let's try those cold frames.
What?
Cold frames.
I don't know what that means.
I don't know either. Gardening stuff, but also British.
Ho ho! That's what I call suction.
Wish you wouldn't.
Why not?
Yeah, I don't know.
I'll use me bun gun for the suction.
Daisy bun gun.
Like a champion. No.
Here comes another bunch of bunnies.
If you offer to do the bun gun on Daisy, she will slap you.
Hey Daisy, now that we're back in your hometown, why do people call you the bun gun?
Suddenly I'm filled with rage.
Oh look, I wonder how he got up there. Try shooting the weather vane to get him down. Fire one of those paint pots up at it now. Point the bun
gun
absolutely. Towards the weather vane.
Just bring the fucking thing. Look.
I used to have what's it called? Top of the shed. I've got a plan. It was a Wallace and Gromit alarm clock. And it would just be Wallace talking to Gromit as the alarm instead of anything like grating. So you would just say something over and over, but if you hit snooze, he would change it to, "Come on, Gromit, don't be lazy bones." It was charming.
I can handle this.
I hope so. Whoa! Alright, try it again.
A job for me, I think.
I hit the wrong one. Try it again. Okay. I like how you whistle for him like he is a dog. This door. I don't know if this is what he wanted me to do, but it's what I'm doing now. There we go.
I'm pretty sure this is some kind of form of prejudice.
Let's have a word with Lady Tottington.
Oh yeah, we kicked those sickos out of this place a long time ago.
I saw the last of you limeys. Get out of my town!
Easy.
What?
Daisy pointing
white. I know,
you're
wonderful, wonderful. I must tell my friends how good you are. Here's another of those pretty little cards for your collection.
I'm going to be paying you money.
As long as you give us some cheese at some point, like, fuck's sake.
Oh, Wallace. May I call you Wallace? You've done such a splendid job. You couldn't do me one more teeny-meeny favor, could you? I must send those statues back before anyone sees them. They're simply ghastly.
They look like those novelty cut French fries.
Collect them up. There are six in all.
Like the face ones.
Yeah.
Look, lad. You'd better wall jump up there.
Yeah?
Do you wall jump,
Gromit? That's really fucking weird to hear Wallace say, actually. I don't like hearing him say video game things.
Oh. Oh wow, this didn't crop well at all.
Whoa. Where are the others? Other places that I presumably must... No. Oh, the walled garden. The Wallace garden.
Over the Gromit Wallace.
Ah, marvelous.
Any more?
There's the next one. Oh, there's no way you're gonna get up there.
I think you should animation cancel for that, lad.
I'll have to get...
Catch this overhead, boy! Oh, we actually can swap. I'm so weirdly tall.
Let's have a look in the walled garden.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing. The real... The real co-op started here.
Look at this rickety old door, lad. I'll bet there's something inside. Both of us to get this open.
The sun is shining, the birds are singing. On days like this, kids like you should be ducking into a bit of Wensley Day.
Oh, look, there's one of those ghastly statues. The butler must have hidden it away.
Damn butler.
Look out there, lad. That's the next one to get. Why didn't we see it before?
I saw it. I just didn't say anything.
Double jump, right. That's in the bag. Let's tell Lady Tottington we got them all, shall we, lad?
I'm not playing Metal Gear anymore. I should probably change that.
No, this is Metal Gear.
Yeah, this is Metal Gear Solid 3. It's Konami Classic. I'm hearing sparklers. Wallace and Gromit. There's actually like way more Wallace and Gromit video games now. this game used to be just the novelty of Wallace and Gromit in a video game, and that was it. And then Telltale came around and started making shit.
Is there a Wallace and Gromit Telltale?
I thought that's what it was. An adventure game? Oh god. Okay.
I mean, that makes sense.
Just never considered it.
Yeah.
Well, done it again, Mr. Wallace. I can see you're a man of considerable abilities.
Tom Gromit. Good job, Sam. I mean, Max.
I mean...
Let's go.
I think if they swapped places, Max would just eviscerate Wallace.
Pest controllers.
Probably.
Antipesto are our last hope. Only they can save the giant vegetable competition, says Lady Tottington.
I think that.
We'll see about that.
Sam and.
Pay Antipesto a visit, Philip. It would be a tragedy if all
Sam
the
and Gromit would be to escape. Perturbed by one another.
Fluffy-headed filly will soon change her tune. And I think they would objectively be creeped out. Deceitfully will come to the rescue with old faith. I feel like Max, it's like a coin flip whether he just kills Wallace or like becomes best friends with him and like churns his life around. Or just like sees him as a novelty.
Like
a dog.
Yeah, like Max might just kill this guy because he's bothering Wallace.
Yeah. Because, well, you know, Sam and Max are a lawful set.
Well.
Believe it or not. I think so. Well, or at least, okay, a good set.
Yeah.
I suppose they're more verging on chaotic. But
ultimately, they are good.
They have this weird line threading of lawful and chaotic.
Mind manipulation only. Huh? Why were you building this, Wallace? Hey, presto!
Rabbit rehabilitation! I don't know if that's how the...
These rabbits look horrifying, by the way.
So does Gromit!
The rabbits can be safely released without fear of reoffending. Problem solved! Just a little added lunar power to enhance the mind waves.
It's a good fucking sentence. Now this I genuinely forgot as a plot point. And we can
begin. I'm building a little bunny panopticon, Gromit.
Veg bad. Veg bad. Veg bad.
I'll cause the little bastards to starve Veg themselves.
Carrots, cabbage.
Pumpkins.
Well, come on, lad. What are you waiting for? Turn on the bun vac. Full suction.
Yeah.
Good lever.
Fucking turn that suck dial way up.
Oh, it's like a hair.
Yeah, it's the hairstyle. Why would you put it so close? Horrifying. God, I... Scared Gromit is always a delight. Just the silent pantomime of screaming.
Well, I think I'll turn in. That experiment's left me brain waves feeling distinctly choppy. No snoozy chock for me tonight. Carrot juice would be just fine.
Yeah, this is like a weirdly just straight retelling. Like, reanimated.
Yeah.
God. Forgot about the, like, alert system.
Oh, I don't like him on
dog mode. He does occasionally engage dog mode.
Wrong.
By heck, I had some dreams last night. Oh! Where's our rabbits? And who's taken me mind-o-matic valve? It's stuck. Connect up the bun vac. We'd better get to work, lad, or Auntie Pesto's name's gonna be mud.
You're excited for the new Shonen Jump game that got announced?
Nope.
My Hero Academia Battle Royale.
Another one?
I need your help.
Oh wait, a battle royale, like an actual one.
Yeah. Weird.
How many My Hero games have there been, and how many have actually been good?
I wouldn't know. Probably not.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Enough!
Hello, Mr. Groback.
We've been unleashed upon this world with little to do.
It's an open world, Gromit.
Didn't expect that one.
Hello, Mr. Windfall.
I'm glad they're named.
Greetings.
Not her, though.
Good day.
Oh, you got to say for yourself.
Has anyone reported these fly posters to PC, Mac?
Huh?
British.
Yeah, for real. I'm sorry, speak English, please? It's July 4th.
Greetings.
In my time zone. Really fired up the most British game I could.
The second July 4th ended. Time for the British.
Yeah, they're coming. Let's just fire up Max Gentleman next.
No, that's what I call suction.
Yeah. I have a couple more. Speaking of achievements that aren't pleasant, I have a couple more to get on Max Gentleman that are just like
grindy.
Do this over and over, yeah. And I manufactured my own undoing by picking like the same opener 6 times over the course of playing the game.
I should start it at some point.
It's a fun game. It's got something for everybody, truly. I am fairly impressed at the sheer variety of just like all the options of stuff offered in that game. And what you might be into as far as your tastes and potential titillation go. At the After Dark stream. I'll be gar- I have no idea where I'm supposed to be doing. And I don't think that's a very good sign.
Are we saying this game might not be amazing?
I'm sure it seems fine. Fuck off. You. Goodbye. Killing, violence.
Help!
I need to.
Let's make freaking lose it. Get out of your mind.
I also need to do 12 different starts and train 100 Kingsmen, and the 100 Kingsmen will probably be done very soon, especially because initial end game. I don't know if that counts for the achievement, but, like, really lets you go crazy on that.
I'm having a week coming up where I won't have my PC, but I'll have a laptop. Maybe I should start that then.
It's a great laptop game. Okay. I think I'm over this. I'm over Wallace and Gromit.
That's specifically a Wallace voice, and I'm struggling with it. Because it keeps becoming Australian.
Yeah. You interact with too many Australians, I guess. I can't say I don't do the same sometimes. Fucking, I don't know.
to fire up one more thing, just as kind of a messing around. What are we thinking? You remember?
Put on
choices?
Tony Hawk and get the stream DMCA'd as the final.
Fuck yeah, segment. Or Midnight Club. I think that would also do the job. Either of those will fill
my shit with licensed soundtracks.
Funny, smart, richly entertaining, and superbly crafted.
Which game do you think that describes?
Wallace and Gromit.
Tony Hawk Pro Skater 4.
Does Wallace and Gromit have reviews?
Hold on.
No. I think they knew better. It's like, I got, this is like a fully packed thing. Like, I have a manual and everything. Which is cute. They like flavored it like it's the Toddington Records office briefing files. It's got a space to write notes in. Classic gaming.
I'm gonna fire up Midnight Club just for like a little. It's because we're in the Midnight Club for most time zones, except for mine.
Make us members of the Midnight Club.
Shut the hell your mouth. Drop Wallace and Gromit to the floor. Kick them to the fucking curb.
Jake's just saying never again and just frisbeeing the disc out the window.
I don't want to do destruction of video games unless I'm filming it. I feel like
one
that's
a
microwave. Lost opportunity. Yeah. See, that's a perfect scenario.
And then buy a new microwave, probably.
I don't know if I can do that one. I don't think it'll ruin the whole thing if you just put it in for a few enough seconds that it makes it spark and crack the entire disc. It's fine.
Have I ever told the story of how my brother broke a microwave?
No, please do.
He put in one of those mac and cheese cups.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't add water.
Nice.
And it became a black ball of pasta and rubber.
That's
and
amazing.
Smoke alarms went off. And then that microwave just would not... You couldn't get it to not hit things full blast.
I only unleash all of my power.
Yeah, he broke the limiters on it. And so we had to get a new one.
I'm gonna start this intro and go to the bathroom real quick.
Reading disc. No, folks, it seems like she's not starting shit, actually.
I'm not gonna start it.
Nope. PlayStation 2 making a fucking fool out of you. There we go.
There we
That's the noise. Oh god, just hearing the noise made me want to fucking play the game.
If you said anything in the past 10 seconds, I didn't hear it. Because my headphones got disconnected.
Hearing the noise made me want to fucking put on a PS2 game.
Yeah. Alright, I think this will be the last thing for the night. I'm just going to mess around in this game for a little bit, because...
I kind of want to fucking play Sly Cooper right now.
I wish I had a Sly Cooper. This game is mixed loud as fuck. But yeah, this game came to my attention because it had a pretty faithful recreation of San Diego as its opening zone. And by pretty faithful, I mean highly compressed.
Sure.
And you might be thinking, like, oh yeah, that's by virtue of this being a PS2 game, the city, of course, has to be small. But it has to be even smaller because they made 3 cities for this game. Which I think they should have just made the entire a highly detailed San Diego and just went for it. I would love a remake of this game. Because this is like the only rep we have ever gotten outside of one Tony Hawk level. And that was a pretty cool Tony Hawk level.
Video game set.
Yeah, I don't know if there's others. I don't know them. Hey, I know those buildings.
Call of Duty Ghosts.
Boo.
What is Asphalt 8? Oh, it's a bike racing game.
Yeah.
Asphalt 8.
Sure.
Hey, Chaos Island, The Lost World.
Yeah, sure.
Park game.
Yeah, sure. Okay. I don't need Jorf. Been a minute. We got networking.
Yeah. The game's final level. There's a bonus mission where you play as a T-Rex tearing through San Diego to meet up with a baby on a freighter.
Yeah. That's how Lost World ends.
Death Race 1990.
Lego Jurassic Park should have. Lego Jurassic World. Should have that
Demolition Man
thing.
The video game.
Fuck. I gotta find that.
So this Demolition Man is a pair of action video games based on a film of the same name. Flame Entertainment published the 16-bit version, which features run-and-gun gameplay for the Super NES, Sega Genesis, and Sega CD. Virgin Interactive released a completely different game for the 3DO that combined several distinct gameplay styles.
I like how you can change your nickname in this.
Hitman Blood Money.
Huh.
Jurassic World Evolution, Lego Jurassic World.
Yeah. It's called 619 Customs!
This game... Need for Speed Nitro.
Not Need for Speed Nitro.
Kitchen.
What?
A video game called Kitchen.
I forgot I made a V-Drops Hive Mobile.
Alright. Pretty good.
This is bees!
Kitchen is a 1994 racing video game developed by EA for the Sega Genesis.
Awesome. You have to watch the car leave.
Yeah. Tony Hawk's Underground, Top Gun Combat Zones.
Sure, okay.
And then
you know, Warpath, another Jurassic Park game.
I don't remember making this.
There's also separate subcategories for Major League Baseball games and National Football League Football League video games.
I mean, yeah, fair. A couple stadiums of those. Here's my very generic tuner. It's the Gracemobile. Yeah, Grace 27. So you know this is a new fucking save. Though I've dug up some ancient Thorson lore that is not canon anymore in a few games. Which is kind of a nonsense sentence to most people, but let me tell you. I had some plans for certain characters that don't exist anymore. Let's play the B-drops car.
How it goes sometimes.
Exit the garage. What is the Dark Thorson lore? I have a game where I can reveal this, and I might want to play at some point soon. It's not technically about Grace. It was supposed to be the true identity of a certain character. Might have been related to Grace.
Oh my god, when they kept blocking the attic.
Yeah. Player, you don't know Star Trek? Anyways, downtown San Diego, semi-faithfully recreated. Where are we going? I forget the... There you go. So, for some reason, like it's some kind of Pokemon game, the map is turned on its side 90 degrees. As this is the West Coast, but it's on the South. I wish I could just point a pointer at this map. But like around here, I think is like kind of SeaWorld. It's like there's like a middle section here that like should be stretched out significantly between SeaWorld and Balboa Park. They let you jump over a tank that is generic. There's some like cool highways in San Diego that I kind of wish would be more faithfully recreated. I mean, they suck to drive in, but like for a racing game, I think they would be pretty fun. This is Balboa Park. What's it called? Kind of like right next to the San Diego Zoo. So it's a very popular spot. Really nice just area. Full of like museums and science centers and more museums. The Museum of Photographic Arts is there. There's an 100-year-old carousel that we got to film on for that movie we're doing. Got some really cool shots of that. I think this is the fountain, the main fountain plaza, where I think this is the Reuben H. Fleet Science Center, which would mean, yeah, that's the, here's the Natural History Museum.
Kind
of. This is where the Tony Hawk level is also. This is like where it starts.
It's been a while since I've been to the closest science center around here. The museum's even a little further out than that.
What was this fucking terrible soundtrack?
I'm in the house like carpet.
I'm in the house like carpet. Like, genuinely. I saw the... And to my point, I saw a landmark from SeaWorld while trying to approach Balboa Park, which is funny. Also, those, I forget what those buildings are called with the green tops, but that's a very famous set of buildings. It's, in the skyline on our local news station.
I'm certain I've seen something aping those in a video game at one point.
They're a pretty cool set of buildings. How do I honk the horn? Oh, that's the nitrous. That's distinctly not the horn. Is
there
not a horn in this game?
He gave you his keys and now you're just doing this shit.
Yeah. I can afford it.
Get a car for every bee.
I lost that landmark I was looking for. And also, I lost the ability to drive. Why did I start this track over? I don't know. There's like one track in this whole thing that I recognize. And I don't remember what it was, but I'm gonna...
Is that ska?
Not quite. It's 50 Cent, but I don't know this one. Let me see here. Yeah, here's Water Park. I found it.
Oh boy. Water Park.
Water Park! Featuring that big old tower that...
Thorny Park. Better, wetter Water Park.
I want to say there is a jump that goes over Water Park. Though I feel like I might be mixing it up with a Burnout Paradise. That said, here we're on this weird dock. No, okay. Get out of my way. Yeah, Water Park seems to be generally actually closed off. What a shame. Yeah, I want to jump Shamu.
Or, you know, as they're probably called in this game, Orca.
The killer whale. Take you around downtown. I'm gonna be in downtown pretty soon because we got a San Diego Comic-Con coming up. And I got tickets to Comic-Con because we got tickets to Comic-Con 2 years ago and then they were like, okay, maybe we won't. But now they're just like, we're not stopping anymore. But yeah, if you drive towards the coast in downtown, here's the convention center. This is fun for me. I like finding... Oh yeah, I forgot this is the updated version with Petco Park. There was a version of this game that didn't have Petco Park in it. And it was just this weird empty lot of something that was about to happen. And they remixed this game twice and it managed to get Petco Park in there.
I miss when stadiums were named after companies.
Me too. Oh, Petco Park's pretty nice. You can ramp Petco Park. Woo! There's the gas lamp district.
Game too.
Yeah, it's not like we're playing important baseball games there. Bar. I attended a fun event in a really pretty club.
Chicago, we're playing in Petco Park this week.
Anyway, oh, this is the song. And It Feeds by Nine Inch Nails.
Huh.
A weirdly good choice. can just do donuts in the Spaceballs day, man. It's so exciting to me. This, like, it was so funny. This was just this conspicuously empty spot because Petco Park was brand new when this came out. They clearly got some tourism department money. Here's some real DMCA shit.
Yeah.
This is in Rock Band 1. This is mostly how I know it.
In Rock Band, it's probably gonna get caught.
Midnight Club is a good racing game series. I also have Midnight Club Los Angeles, which was their Xbox 360 title. And that one has a faithful recreation of L.A., which I can find some fun spots there, too.
The big city I'm closest to is New York, but I don't know it well enough to be like to look at something like Spider-Man and be like, oh, wow, it's so accurate.
GTA 4. Oh, that car just got blasted by the trolley. Was I? Okay, I was in the spot behind the connection.
The trolley plows through evening traffic.
Yeah. Here's a Marriott, I believe, that's next to fucking Convention Center that just sort of became a section of Comic-Con now. Just absorbed.
Man, I don't miss a lot about being in DC, but I miss going to STX every year.
This little spot behind the convention center is nice. I'm just going full tour guide at this part. It doesn't have a ramp like this, but I wish it did. That'd be fun. But it does have this fun little bait shop that sells burgers. That, you know, because it's connected to the port. So there's a bunch of people fishing there. They have a really good, like, chorizo burger that I like getting during convention season. That's, like, most of the stuff that I can generally remember. Also, hey, there's an aircraft carrier. Can we drive fully onto that thing? I think so. Nope, that's just another tunnel. Let me get with the jets. Let me jump off an aircraft carrier. You fucking cowards. No way, I think. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, nope. Yeah, good enough. Sorry, food, cigarette cartons. My bad. There's a really weird building that, like, I can never... I think it's by the, like, big train station in San Diego. Oh, I'm in one of the big train stations in San Diego. This is a distinct stop. Oh, and there's the Star of India. Star of India is a historical ship. I don't know how many people have heard of the Star of India. But it is one of our big tourist attractions because it's an actual historical sailing boat. That is a frequent spot for field trips. And they would do this immersive ship stay thing where you would stay overnight on the ship and pretend you were working on it and sailing. And they would have, like, parents send you letters like you were abroad. And they did running shifts of the night watch and stuff. It was really neat. It's a fun little thing. And they taught you about old sailing techniques and culture and traditions and stuff, superstitions.
What's this thing around that to here? You have to spend the night on like a
Navy ship that was that's been docked at the museum.
I'm back in Balboa. I think I got the relatively early night shift, which was nice. Hey, Phil! What are you doing?
Aw, man, you racing Phil? Be careful out there.
Oh, shit, you racing Phil? He's on a motorbike. He's gonna die. Don't touch me. Now, I don't fully remember how to play this game, but I'll do my best. I figure I should do at least... I should do at least one race.
To the race.
Yeah, it's just an extra thing. It's to get you immersed. Phil!
Oh, he looks so cool.
Phil looks like he sells meth. Which is appropriate.
Yeah.
Phil looks like he sells meth and nobody knows why he races. Like, he's not good at it. But I guess he thinks he is. I don't know, remember how that... Oh, but motorbikes are so fast. But yeah, this is the racing system that's pretty much been entirely adopted by every GTA afterward. The thing with Midnight Club, though they added it in GTA 5, was like cars would have, oh god, their own like special abilities. You would like build up a charge and like do these like moves that would like slow down time or like turn you invincible and let you bash other cars away. Pizza. I don't think I'm in a good car for this race against Phil, the motorbike man, and everyone else who is rubber banding like shit. Well, not really rubber banding, I'm
in the last car. I don't know if the kind of car would matter much with the slamming at the building.
Yeah, that isn't helping. But they got a pretty steady lead on me early. I'm okay. I'll get him on the straightaways. Oh, it was a one lap race. Hey guys, did I win?
I mean, for what it's worth, it seems like Phil was only fourth.
He didn't even win his own race! What the fuck's wrong with you, Phil? Yeah, I'll talk shit from behind you. I was 5 seconds slower than you, but I don't care.
What a tool.
Mr. D. No, let's see. Interface by E-Sassin. Once again, I might need to rub that up
like
better.
There's...
I don't fully know. Cops also sometimes happen. Are they making me just do the same race again? I guess it makes sense since I lost, but still. We got other races to do. Phil, get out of the fucking way. We're doing beach racing.
Under the timer, the game's just calling you a POS.
Yeah. Out.
Well, you should have picked a different car.
Shut up. I'll get a... Hey, we got flip branding. enjoyed that skate brand as a teenager. Mostly because they had an abundance of skulls and occasional gestures. Phil finished for once. What you need to understand is I'm incredibly good at racing. Get it fucked, Phil!
Let's try it again.
That was a different race, I think. No, it wasn't. Absolutely made me restart. Yeah, third time's a charm. I do have nitrous. The wiseness of the nitrous is debatable.
It's on the right.
I'm gonna follow this guy who stays on the street. I think he's got the right idea. We're still in it. We're still working.
It feels slightly different. I know it's insane, but...
Yeah, right? It's kind of weird. Phil, you son of a bitch, I got you. Get out of here.
Killed the man.
Whew! Fuck! Well... I beat Phil. Beat up Liam.
Hey.
We got money.
Wow.
They want you to get first. I'm
probably
leaving.
Fine. Silver's where we're at, baby.
Welcome to Midnight Club, baby. I hope you enjoyed that scenic tour through San Diego, and I hope you enjoyed this 10-hour stream. Or this piece of it, if you're just watching later. Yeah, that's a good noise to cut off on.